According to program officer at the Khomas Health Directorate, Patemoshela Amunyela, tuberculosis and HIV data as of October 2021 shows that there are 22,370 active patients and 789 children currently on ARV treatment. TB cases to date are 898, with treatment success rates at 85%, targeted to be at 90%. Amunyela adds that HIV testing and counseling services are at 100% coverage at all health facilities in the region, with antiretroviral and elimination from mother to child transmissions at 100%.
The death rate due to TB is 7%, and the drug resistance, which means patients that are not reacting to the susceptible TB treatment, the initiative, the first treatment that we are giving to patients, they are now standing at 56%. Those are the ones that are notified this year, but we have quite a cumulative number of them. The ENTCT, as I mentioned, we are currently standing at 98% of HIV exposed infants that are testing negative. And as the patients that are on community adherence groups are at 800, we are doing quite well as a region. Achievements: all facilities have trained staff that can offer TB HIV services. There is a good relationship between stakeholders and the Ministry of Health and other line ministries. Kapura Health Center is operating 24 hours. That's a big achievement in the region. We have community adherence clubs, as I said, or groups, and we are also doing home deliveries of ART to patients, and we are implementing the multi-month dispensing to decongest the health facilities and prevent the transmission of COVID-19 at the facilities.
Country Director for the Society for Family Health applauded the Khomas Region for its performance in HIV response, noting that Namibia has enough weapons to fight the disease, having put in place various forms of treatment for it over the years.
When you look at the knowledge that we have gathered over time to now, Ms. Amunyela was talking about issues around community-based ART that are currently being delivered in our communities. We're talking about pre-exposure prophylaxis, we're talking about post-exposure prophylaxis, which means these are medicine you take if you are HIV negative to stay HIV negative. That's now pre-exposure prophylaxis, while post-exposure prophylaxis is a potential exposure you have to really prevent that you don't get the, you don't acquire HIV. Those are all development. Science has developed over time. Khomas is one of the regions doing very well when it comes to HIV response. Be it a treatment, those who need treatment, getting on treatment, and those who are on treatment who are virally suppressed, meaning that it's unlikely, very minimal, that they will transmit HIV to their counterparts through sexual intercourse, because they are taking their treatment very well, and the treatment is working very well. That's why it's suppressed.
Governor of the Khomas Region at the meeting highlighted the interlink between HIV and AIDS and the COVID-19 pandemic, noting that the required health protocols of the two pandemics are interdependently complicating one another.
In terms of HIV/AIDS, that now we have the pandemic of the COVID-19, we are restricting people to visit one another, and we are saying distance, don't touch each other. But then others, in the case of HIV/AIDS, maybe they need a hug from someone. He says, it is an undeniable truth that our region, as the capital city of this country, has been the epicenter of the TB, hepatitis E, HIV, AIDS, and the current dominating COVID-19 pandemic. And it's of course obvious. This is the center of this country, this is the center of administration, justice, and everything. So everybody, I say it is very scarce that you see a person moving from Khomas Region to another region, but rather coming to Khomas Region. As this pandemic are real in our region and are part of our daily challenges, and we cannot talk about the one without mentioning the other. These practical realities alone must be a wake-up call for us to reorganize ourselves in terms of our effective response to these health challenges, all of them that I just mentioned. We must all refrain from the misconception of seeing these health challenges as the sole responsibility of the affected ones and the Ministry of Health alone, but our joint obligation as a resident of this great region.